Le temps que passe un roi à gouverner ressemble à la course du soleil. Un jour viendra où le soleil éteindra sur moi sa lumière et se lèvera pour faire de toi le nouveau roi.
On virtually every Disney film since Snow White, okay, we tried to put our films into a local language to reach the broadest possible audience.
Hakuna Matata?
Yeah, det er vores motto.
Bad motto?
Ikke noget, men det rimer på lotto.
The challenges there are to find the right cast that has resonance with the local community. Then we also have to find the right adaptation of the language.
We've been fortunate enough to have some of the finest lyricists and translators around the world who take the English version of our films and adapt them to the local cultures. They understand all the local sensitivities as well as the comedy of the region, so that they can really take the script and take it into that culture so that they can relate to it the way we related to it in the United States.
We just want to make sure wherever you go in the world, we have that consistency from a performance standpoint. Not only the intent of what is being said by the characters, but also the characters' full range of personality.
Schleimig, geht auch wieder mit ihm raus.
And now, the way that we accomplish that is our individual offices cast the characters or various talent and then send the auditions to Burbank. And by having that one central hub, we're able to make sure that every territory around the world has a consistent voice.
Kom hit ett tag!
Va?
Nala, det här är Pumbaa. Pumbaa, Nala.
Trevligt att råkas!
Lion King was a unique one in the fact that it was the first film that we ever went out day and date in 8 languages. And what that actually meant was we had to start recording the foreign language versions as the domestic version was being completed.
I've had great experiences going out to a lot of new countries to find the talent, find the directors, and one of the highlights of the dubbing experience for me was going into South Africa to do the Zulu version of Lion King. They didn't record any Zulu. I mean, this was kind of a first.
Blake's experience down there was pretty unique in that he literally went to the local schools to cast talent to find the voice of young Simba and young Nala, and then went in just into the community to find anybody who could play the various roles. I think it's incredible what he was able to accomplish with basically non-actors and non-singers. It was great.
Getting the Zulu version done for the same day and date release was an incredible effort, and they did a phenomenal job. It was just amazing how natural it sounded. It felt like it really could have originated in Zulu. The localization of The Lion King was so precedent-setting that it received front-page recognition in Variety, as well as it caused a lot of debate within the majors as to how far to dub a film. And today, we dub our films in about 32 languages, which seems to be the right mix. It was also the first time ever our local language soundtracks ever scored, you know, huge sales. And it was because of this that laid the foundation to our international star talent casting and international, you know, recording artist casting in subsequent films. And also, the process that we went through on The Lion King set the stage for the worldwide DVD release now day and date. Disney clearly is a worldwide recognized brand, and I think it's because of our commitment to that brand that we really succeeded.